Modern medicine is mostly a one drug, one target approach to medicine. We look at it as the greatest thing because it is. It's the thing that we have demonstrated proof of efficacy for. And we can not only say that it works, but we can also say how it works. And that's kind of a cool thing about modern medicine. What we have done with modern medicine is we have drawn from traditional knowledge what has been known to be effective in nature, taken those things and brought that knowledge into what we are doing in modern medicine by taking a plant, extracting a drug from it, and using that drug. And that's actually the root for most drugs that we have today. As a matter of fact, something like 60 to 80% of all modern medicines were originally derived from natural sources, from plants, from bacteria, from fungi, from yeast, and either used directly or go through that optimization process, and then the optimized compound used directly. The project that I've been working on the most lately is on hawthorn. I focus on plants and bacteria that have medicinally active properties or compounds in them. Hawthorn has a long tradition on three continents in traditional medicine for treating congestive heart failure. Since we know that three places independently came up with, if we use this leaf, flower, or berry, we have this effect on people with heart problems. That's a real sign that that particular family of plants is a rich source of potential bioactive compounds or mixtures of bioactive compounds. So what we're doing is looking at how the chemistry between these three regions is the same and also look at why they're different. One of the hard things about working on these plant species is that any plant, really any living organism, produces a lot of different molecules, up to 40,000 that we know of, for example, in a leaf tissue. We have to look at what it is in those 40,000 compounds that drives the physiological response. We use a tool called nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy to do that, and that tool is our window into the structure of molecules. One of the really fun things about this research is when a student comes in on the project, it's not the kind of work where you focus on pure chemistry or pure botany or pure statistics, but instead they get to look at the boundaries between those three fields, because without understanding the botany of the plants, you don't have any way to understand whether or not you're going to see a difference in the chemistry. And without understanding the chemistry, you're going to have a hard time interpreting whether or not those things are the same or different. And both of those tie into how do you use statistics to say this plant species is chemically different than that plant species. The reason we find this work so exciting is because we are looking at a different paradigm in some ways than the modern medicine paradigm, where one single compound produces our biological effect. Also, the natural health products that you buy in the market or in the store, it is very challenging to tell the difference between one green powder that's a leaf ground up and another green powder that's a leaf ground up. The tools we use for our work also help us authenticate products that are on the market today to make sure they are what they say they are, and that you can actually expect the response to taking that pill to be consistent between different products.